Hi, my name's Armand Morin, and it is day 40 of my 90-day video challenge. And today, I want to talk about one thing, and that is called improvement. Now, we can all stand to improve anything that we could possibly do. It can always have a little bit more improvement in order to make it better, of course. Well, let's take this video and the videos that I've been doing on a daily basis. There's a lot of things that I like about my videos, but there's also a lot of things that I can see that needs a bit of improvement. And let me tell you what I've been doing and what I've been researching and what I can do to make it better. Sound good? So let's take this video. Now, the first thing is when you notice that you started playing this video, there was just kind of a blah. It was just like, hi, my name is Armand Morin and this is day 40, right? And that's all good. That's good. That's fine, right? Except how can we make it better? Well, what we can do is we could put a little bit of an intro to the front of this, a little opener, maybe 5 seconds to 8 seconds on the very beginning of the video to make it good. Maybe have my logo come in a little bit and maybe just a little bit of music. And that would kind of set the tone for my video. So that's one thing that I've been looking at, and I've almost got this nailed down. And in the next few videos, you'll probably see me actually do it. Number two is the idea of as I'm speaking, just like I'm talking to you right now, is to have a little music underneath my voice. In other words, have a little music underneath, kind of looping in the underneath it, and it makes it sound, I think, a little bit more interesting. I think also, while I'm speaking, if I'm mentioning something or referencing something, I can kind of splice that piece that to give you a visual of whatever it is that I'm referencing, that I'm talking, even if it's a website, or even if it's something I did that day or whatever, I could kind of insert that. In other words, maybe increase the production value of these videos. Now, even though my videos aren't really, really long, they're only, you know, maybe 10, 15 minutes at tops at best. But the fact is that throughout that time frame, if you look at most movies, any kind of entertainment, the video or the camera is kind of zooming in or it's zooming out or it's panning. And also at the same time, the music underneath it kind of sets the tone for what it is that we're doing. So again, I think that's another area that we could do. So again, so number two and three would be music underneath of what I'm speaking, right? You like how I do that? Music underneath. And then at the same time, splicing in. I think this whole thing is all about hand motions. You have to put the music underneath it and then splice it in with the other things that I'm talking about as I'm talking about them. So that's kind of a good thing. What else can I improve? Well, yeah, I mean, content is always content. You can always have better content. And I think no matter what you say, no matter what you do, you always could do something better. And that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. If you notice on my videos, I don't do jump cuts at all. Maybe I should try that in my next video, is to kind of, you know, when I'm pausing or if I'm maybe taking too long to talk about something, you can jump cut and it just kind of bypasses that and makes it maybe a little bit more interesting. And I've never really done that before. Maybe once or twice just messing around, just playing with it. But it's something I think I could try. Maybe I would like it, maybe I don't, who knows. Another thing, this in back of me, this set. The set is not bad. It is something I've used on and off for a lot of different things that I do, for different programs and products and services that I have. I record right here and it's, there's nothing wrong with it. I like it. I think my pictures in the background, I think we could change those. Those are just something I threw up the last minute. I've got a bunch of paintings and things of that nature I want to put back there. I've thought about putting some shelves back there, something, maybe a couple of things to hang on there. I got a couple of cool medals and stuff like that. I thought about hanging back there as well too. So I think that there's, let's put it this way. I think that the backdrop that I have back here could use a much more nicer touch to it. Maybe it's a woman's touch. Maybe I need to get my wife up here to take a look and see how we can improve that. And we've got a couple other sets actually in this room. For example, I've got a big TV screen wall that we're going to be showing, and you'll start seeing more of that. And we'll probably be switching back and forth between this set and another set. And I think that'd be kind of cool. What else could we do? Could we improve upon it? Well, I could use props maybe, but I kind of like this open area. I like there's not a lot that I do that's minimalistic, but I like this. This is minimalistic to me. Okay. There's nothing. It's a clean desk that's in front of me. So I like that. You know, I'm trying to think of what else could we possibly do to improve it, right? I think maybe at the end, we could do a couple different things, maybe more utilizing you know, where you're referencing another video and trying to get people to watch more videos. I think that's a possibility of what we could do. I'm just trying to think of what else could we possibly do. Maybe, oh, here's the big one, right? So I thought about this and I mentioned this to my wife the other day and I was like, well, you know, I'm doing this like every day, but maybe I could do like Monday, this topic, Tuesday, this topic, Wednesday, this topic, Thursday, this topic, and Friday, this topic. So this way I don't have to, I'm not just talking about anything randomly. It's like Monday's this topic, Tuesday's this topic. And this way I'm kind of staying focused on that one topic for each day that I'm actually recording, and Saturday and Sunday and all the other good stuff. That would be also kind of cool. I think we could do that, and that's very easily done. And we've thought about all of this. The other things are like minor details, right? It's like up here, I want to put like a light, this kind of a backlight on my head and on my shoulders a little bit to create more separation. I think that would be good. I'd like a small light in the background, maybe shining up. I think that would be kind of cool as well too. There's just a lot of details, you know. I love the idea of videos. I love the idea of making films and things of that nature. And I think it's fascinating. And I watch a lot about, I go to YouTube a lot and I watch a lot about these things because I don't think you can ever learn enough. And honestly, I know nothing. I know nothing about recording video. I just learned the pieces that I need to know in order to get me to that next step. I know nothing about lenses. And so everything that I do is kind of an experimentation in trying to make my videos maybe just a little bit better and kind of gradually make them better as I go. And I think it's fun. You know, for me, it's kind of fun doing it. But at the same time, I think it's where you can try a lot of different things. I was just watching a bunch of videos earlier. And I've got this big master plan. And let me just share this with you guys right now. So here's the plan. So I've been using this set here, if you will, for a lot of the videos that I've been shooting lately. In fact, all the videos that I've been shooting, unless I'm out traveling doing something else. I have another, this would be the time I'd take a picture to show you this, but I have four big 55-inch television screens that I put together to make a video wall. And you'll see that in upcoming videos. And if you see some of the earlier videos I've done last year or so, I've done some videos with them back then. And I think that's going to be our second set over there. I just need to make it easier for me to switch between sets. That's really my big hang up without having to move the cameras and move the lighting and everything else. It's just, if it's difficult, you probably won't do it. That's typically what happens. But we also have one other room, and the other room is downstairs. It's a secret. And here's what happened. We had to redo this whole room. It was originally a movie theater in my house. We never used it for that. I set up and I did some videos in there before, but what we're going to do is we're setting up this room to have permanent video lighting, which is really going to be kind of cool to actually see. And I need to make a new desk. This is just something that we had and I've been using this, but I'm making a custom desk in order to do this with, but also at the same time is for me to be able to interview people as well. And so it's going to be really kind of neat, because we have it set up for like three different video scenarios in that one room. So I'm really excited for that. And we're probably going to start working on that maybe towards the latter part of the year. So my point today is all about improvement. You see, I'm never satisfied with what I have. And you can say that that's good. And you could probably make the argument that that's bad too. But the reality is I'm not looking to improve it for other people. And oddly enough, I'm not doing it for you. I'm doing this for me, because in my opinion, I want this to look a certain way. In my opinion, I think I can make it better. In my opinion, I think I can make a better experience. And as long as I have that idea in the back of my head that I can improve it and that I can make it better, then I'm going to make small incremental improvements as I go. And sometimes they may be huge jumps, but a lot of things that we have to try is we just have to try it, see how it works, and then move on. In fact, some of the things I might try, I might hate. And you know what? That's okay. You see, everyone has their own opinion, everyone has their own taste, but also at the same time is you don't know unless you try. So when it comes to something like this with video, again, I don't know everything there is to know about video, but I do know this is that with the little tiny pieces, I can try different things to try to make it better. And you'll probably hear me talk more about video as we go on. But the lesson for today is improvement. You need to improve. You know, you, Mr. Miyagi said, this side of the road, okay. That side of the road, okay. Middle of the road, squish, just like grape. Remember that. So, anyway, improvement, remember it, keep it, and always remember to try to improve yourself. Again, my name is Armand Morin. I will talk to everyone soon. Bye-bye, everybody.